Hello again, and welcome to Go Visit Castles.
This time we've travelled to Shropshire on the trail of the Knights Templar, and this is Ludlow Castle.
Ludlow Castle was built in 1080 and was one of the first stone castles built in England. During the First Civil War, the castle changed hands many times and was further fortified with a keep and a large outer bailey. When King Stephen took the castle in 1139, he rescued Prince Henry of Scotland, who was dangling from a grappling hook on the castle walls. Ludlow Castle was built as a defensive castle along the border between England and Wales. Because the Welsh were supporting the English in their rebellion against the Normans, the area became known as the Welsh Marches, and William the Conqueror created earldoms along the marches, and he granted these earls the powers that the English lords didn't have. They had the power to build castles, to raise taxes, to control the countryside, and they didn't need the king's permission from any of these. And it's from castles such as Ludlow that the Normans would continue their attacks into Wales.
We're very lucky today because we have Leon, who is Ludlow Castle's resident archaeologist.
Well, it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure to be here and invite you into this fabulous Norman castle, 11th century military building. It is absolutely fabulous. There is a whole wealth of archaeology here. It all relates back to the castle back in that period between 1086 and 1093, when it was first built.
Now, what I've noticed inside the Norman keep, round about where that window is, what looks to me to be like murder holes upstairs in the Norman keep, but there's no gatehouse here. What's going on?
Well, you're bang on there. They are, in fact, murder holes. There's three of them. And what it's showing is a change of function. So originally, what you've got is the entrance here to the castle. That entrance that we see now was put in 1501.
Okay.
The entrance would have been like a great, you wanted to have pomp and ceremony, but also because it was a military building originally, its function was really defensive. So the reason why you've got the murder holes, should you make it across, the other side and get inside, you then have the problem of having boiling oil and all kinds of nastiness and naughtiness being tipped on top of your head as a defensive measure. There is actually, in actual fact, another murder hole in the Mortimer's Tower.
Okay.
It's been much changed, this monument. And in fact, the entrance is filled in there. You've got the three windows that were put in later. But as you know, with these defensive castles, they should have long slits.
For a first-time visitor to Ludlow Castle, you might think that what's behind me is a defensive round tower, but you'd be wrong. It's actually a round chapel, and a very rare and a very important one as well. So let's go inside, let's take a closer look. So this brilliant round chapel, Joe, was built by Gilbert de Lacy in the first part of the 12th century. And Gilbert actually became a Knight Templar.
Fantastic.
And the chapel is dedicated to St. Mary Magdalene.
Okay.
The whole place has got very strong
Templar connections with it. And if you know where to look, there's Templar symbology all over this ground chapel.
So you're thinking with the 13 seats that we've got as well, because I noticed that there are 14 archers, but you've got a seat missing there. And looking outside, you can see it's been bricked up. This has never been a seat, has it? So you've got the 13 seats on the outside.
The 13 seats, were they 13 Templar knights?
Well, I do know that the owner of the castle in the 13th century, that he joined Edward I on one of his crusades as well as recompense for his part in the Barons' War with Simon de Montfort. So there were Templar connections there as well at the time of Edward I. The design itself, sort of replica of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem, which was renowned for the Templar activity as well.
Absolutely
stunning. It is. So yeah, definitely strong Templar links. The castle played a part in the Second Barons' War, with Simon de Montfort briefly taking the castle before being acquired by Roger Mortimer and held by the Mortimers for over a century whilst they defended the border between England and Wales. It was inherited by Richard, Duke of York, in 1425 and was held by Royalists during the Second Civil War until it was besieged by the Parliamentarians. Arthur Tudor was the eldest son of King Henry VII, and at the age of six he was sent here to Ludlow Castle to set up his court as the Prince of Wales. By all accounts, he was a studious and intelligent pupil. He showed all the signs of being a model king. He married Catherine of Aragon, and in 1502 he succumbed to illness and he died here at Ludlow Castle. And his brother, Henry VIII, became the king.
Exploring Ludlow Castle, it's more than met my expectations. Out of all the ruined castles that we've done so far, there is more here than any of them put together.
Oh, absolutely. The details everywhere throughout the castle, which I'm assuming is where you've had the Normans and you've had your medieval times, you've got your Tudor periods, and you can see a huge amalgamation of that throughout the castle, in the brickwork, in the different styles, and that's been fantastic to explore. And there's quite a lot of passageways as well, which I'm a big fan of.
Tons of little passages, dark little corridors. One could only imagine how awesome this castle would have
how
been.
How much fun it would have been when you weren't having battles with people.
You see where all the floors are missing?
Yeah.
Most of the buildings have got maybe two or three floors that are missing.
It's fascinating as well. You've got enormous windows that in some point in the past have been bricked over and now it's a fireplace, but you can still see the remaining of the window above it as well. So you can see the changes to the castle throughout time, which is quite fascinating if you look up and you know what to look for.
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
Yeah, I kind of liked meeting Leon today.
That was the highlight
the
of today, actually.
Leon was amazing.
I gather that Leon is often at the castle as he's a resident archaeologist. So if you do pop down to Ludlow and you see him out and about, pick his brains, because he really, really knows what he's talking about, doesn't he?
And the icing on the cake for me at Ludlow Castle is the Knights Templar link and the round chapel. Superb.
It is beautiful, absolutely beautiful. So what do you think, score-wise, what do we think? It's a ruin, but it's a very extensive ruin. It has fabulous history, panning back from the Norman times.
You score it.
Didn't we score it? I would give it an 8.5.
8.5.
Yeah, there's slightly more to it than most ruined castles that we've been to.
Yes.
I really like the history of this place as well.
The history is incredible.
And the fact that they have their own resident archaeologist is that really, really tops it off for Ludlow. They're very lucky to have that.
Yeah, it's been a thoroughly brilliant day out, isn't it?
It has. The views as well from the towers, definitely worth the long climb up there, isn't it? Yeah, this is a beautiful place. Absolutely check out Ludlow Castle if you're in the area. If you're not, make the trip to come here. It's absolutely worth it. And the town itself is beautiful. So if you've enjoyed this, don't forget to like and subscribe. And we'll see you next time on Go Visit Castles.
We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye-bye.